We are 22 members in the Sri Lankan Parliament, out of 23 members from the Northeast Province. And we are specifically representing the Tamil people in Sri Lanka. So many Tamil people were abducted from the Northeast Province, even from Colombo. So many journalists have been killed. They are threatening even the parliamentarians not to open their mouth.
Do you feel under threat?
Definitely, all the Tamil parliamentarians are under threat. Not only me, my colleagues also under threat. So actually, of course, no, we have to go back. I am here in a small visit. I have to go back. I will be going back on 2nd of the next month. But, you know, in Sri Lanka, whether it's parliamentarians or journalists or intellectuals or anybody else, at the moment, you know, they are very scared to open their mouth, because it's like, you know, Nazis rule or like that, you know. They, if we are support them, okay, are you my friend? Then support us. Or otherwise, you are my enemy. Like George Bush. If you support me, okay, you are my friend. If you criticize me, you are my enemy. That's what the Sri Lankan government is also doing. Most of the area is that belongs to the people, private lands, are under the control of army. So simply the civilians couldn't go back to their own land. They couldn't continue their day-to-day life. Not only that, even the large area in the sea was banned. The fishermen, they can't go to sea. They can't do the fishing. So actually, the people, they are under the army control area. They can't do the fishing. They can't do the agriculture works. Gradually, you know, they have to depend on the government for day-to-day life.
So these people have been taken from their land and they're put where?
They're in the refugee camps. They're in the refugee camps. Actually, even last 15 years, more than 100,000 people, they are in the refugee camp only in Jaffna, apart from other areas. You see? So actually, when we were asking that, the government is not cooperating with us, because government always listen to the army. Army always sees things through the security point of view. They said if they allow the people, there will not be any security for them. So when we say that, look, you know, there is a ceasefire agreement. You know, if you go ahead with that, started to talk with LTT, find a proper settlement, then you have to go for that. Why are you thinking about the war? Right? You know, if you think about the war, then you have to, you know, do so many things and you will go towards the war. But if you think about the peace, then you have to, you can go towards that. But you know, if you are not loving the people, you know, we are in a position couldn't answer them, because that is their land. The fishermen, they couldn't go to the sea. You know, what is their livelihood? They don't want to allow the people live in their own area. Genocide in various ways. Chase them away, kill them, put them in the refugee camp. You see, you know, if they are in the refugee camp, there's no education, no facilities, nothing. You know, end of the day, what will happen? They will assimilate with the Sinhalese. This is what Sri Lankan government wants. Sri Lankan government wants to establish as a, single ethno country. They want to establish the single Buddhist supremacy across the Sri Lankan state. This is what they want. This is why basically they started the war. In fact, they want to continue this war. In the place called Vavaniya, there are three camps under the control of army. It's all, you know, looked after by army. Even the parliamentarians or the people's representative, even they can't enter. It's like a detention camps. Once you go there, the people can't go out.
What do you mean they can't go out?
Because the army will not allow them to go out for whatever any purpose. They have to be within the camp. It's like a detention camp. No, without the permission of the army, you can't go out. The army will not give you the permission. For a small example, actually, the ICRC brought about 300 injured people from the war zone area to Vavaniya. 200 injured people and say about 110 or 120 people, they were supposed to look after these injured people. The 5-year-old child, 8-year-old child, they lost their hands, lost their legs, they were admitted in the hospital. But after 10 minutes, all these people who were supposed to look after their children were taken away and they put in the detention camp. the child is crying in the at the hospital. He wants to see her parents, her mother. Mother is crying from the camp. She wants to see his son or daughter in 5 years. Nobody is there to look after them. But the government didn't allow. The government didn't allow them to go. Actually, my colleague in Vavaniya, he called me. He said, look, you know, this is what happening. The army is not allowing, you know, the parents to go to the hospital and see the children. Do something. I went to the Indian High Commission. I met the Indian High Commissioner. I told him, look, you know, this is what happening. Do something. And he called the Defense Secretary. But Defense Secretary said, no, we can't allow them. Whoever they are coming from, when they are all our tigers, we have to screen them. We can't simply allow them to go. Yeah, I'm sorry. The High Commissioner couldn't do anything. This is absolutely a humanitarian thing. Small child, 5 years, 7 years, 8 years. They were separated from the mother, father. They are in the hospital. Who is going to look after them? This is how actually the war zone area or the so-called welfare camps, all those things are like this.
So when people are taken to the welfare camp, how long are they expecting to stay there?
So far there is no stipulated time, but according to the information which we are getting, they are going to be there for another 5 to 10 years. They are not going to allow them to resettle. They are, you know, taken some areas, about 1,000 hectares. They are going to put up small huts and they are going to keep the people over there. And not only that, there are youngsters, more than 150 youngsters, so far taken by the army or the investigation units, and nobody knows where they are. So the youngsters who are coming from the war zone area to the so-called welfare camp, or the, you know, or the under the control of army, they are just vanishing. Actually, the army has taken them in the nights, and the very next day, nobody knows where they are. That is a situation. You know, now the ICRC is taking the injured people by sea from the war zone area to a place called Tringamalai. The Tringamalai, there's again a Tamil area where, as I told you, my parliamentary group leader belongs to that area, Mr. Sambandhan. He conducted the doctor and he said, I want to come and meet the injured people because he's an elected representative from that area. The doctor said, well and good, you can come and meet the people, sir, there's no problem. Then he informed the police because as a parliamentarian, he is having a security risk. He informed the police. Police said, you know, that is not under our control, that is the control of the army, please talk to them. Then he conducted the army. In the beginning, army said, okay, sir, you can come, you know, you can see the people. But within 1 hour, they called him again and said, you have to get the permission from the Ministry of Defense, you see, to go to the hospital, which is in his electorate, to meet the Indian people. He has to get the permission from the Ministry of Defense from Colombo. Then he conducted the Ministry of Defense. The secretary is Gotabaya Rajapaksa. He is the brother of the present president. He conducted him and he asked him, look, you know, I want to visit the hospital. I want to see the injured people. I am sorry, sir, you know, you can't go because we are having a policy decision not to allow any other people to the hospital. Then he said, no, in that situation, I have to talk to your brother, the president of this country, to get the permission to go. He said, you know, even the president can't overrule my decision. The defense secretary says, even the president can't overrule my decision. This is how things are functioning in Sri Lanka. Regularly, we are meeting the international community, we are meeting the mission people in Colombo, Americans, British, Europeans, Indians, everybody. We are going all over the world and meeting them, you know, giving, telling them what is happening, what is ground reality. Everybody knew it. Nobody is denying that. Everybody knew that there's a total impunity in Sri Lanka. Everybody knew that there's an unwanted war is going on in Sri Lanka. Everybody knew that the Sri Lankan government is bombarding his own citizens. But we are helpless. Nobody is coming forward to support us. Nobody is coming forward to solve this problem. They are seeing the Sri Lankan government as a state.